Hey guys, I wanted to talk to you about a topic that is very dear and near to my heart, and I couldn't even begin to figure out where to start, so I typed up everything that I want to talk to you. So I'm just going to read it to you. Health, the best investment you can make. No matter what the outcome is for the future, you're going to benefit from taking care of yourself right now. Okay? So let's get started. Limit your intake of refined and processed foods. How to tell if something is bad for you. The less it resembles its original form and you can't figure out where it came from, probably shouldn't be eating it, alright? The more unpronounceable the ingredients are on the label, there's a telltale sign right there. List of foods to stay away from. Refined grains and sugar lack nutrients and will actually leach minerals from your body in order to buffer the acidity during the digestive process. One of the main causes of osteoporosis and osteoarthritis that they don't talk about is sugar, not lack of calcium from milk. We're not suffering from milk deficiencies. Rather, what you're eating is sucking out the minerals in your bones in order to buffer the effects of that food. Soda pop. Alright, I'm sure you've heard this, like, many times. High fructose corn syrup, phosphoric acid, this is one of the worst things that you can include in your diet. Just don't drink it. And don't fall for that diet soda or Pepsi Zero bullshit. I mean, Splenda, NutraSeat, and aspartamine are known neurotoxins, okay? And they also make you fatter, just in case you didn't know. If it is packaged, canned, and will last on a shelf indefinitely, it is dead food. Okay, this will provide extra calories in a survival situation. I'm not knocking it, but as you're trying to get healthy, avoid these items if at all possible, or minimize their consumption. TV dinners and frozen foods. These are better for long-term use, as they will stay good for extended periods of time, but remind yourself that they are essentially dead foods. While they might provide you with added fiber and calories, the process by which they are frozen and reheated will essentially strip them of any nutritional value. I understand we're busy people. Once in a while, eating a TV dinner, warming up something like that is the only way to go. But try to avoid it. Try to eat as fresh as possible. Okay? Avoid polyunsaturated oils like canola, peanut, safflower, corn, soybean, cottonseed oil. These contribute to the calcification of your arteries and atherosclerosis. These oils are hard for your body to digest and will be stored as fat, and they also oxidize quickly, making them unsuitable for cooking at high temperatures. Avoid trans fats and hydrogenated oils, Crisco, margarine. I can't believe it's not butter. You want to stay away from all that stuff. It is not good for you. Instead, use grapeseed oil. It has a high burning temperature and therefore will not go rancid as easily. Coconut oil and palm oil are also good for cooking, but they do have a very distinct taste, and unless you are a Thai food chef, cooking with these oils is going to be tricky. Spaghetti, okay, like that's one of the food groups I discovered, or one of the dishes, that is not good cooked with coconut oil. Okay, so just fair warning. Olive oil is good for dressings and dips, and if you are cooking at a low temperature. Butter is good for cooking at low temperatures, but it can easily go rancid, so make sure you keep it refrigerated and get it cultured if at all possible. Avoid alcohol. And stimulants like coffee and black tea and cigarettes. Now I know there are those of you who are not going to take my advice about avoiding alcohol, so I did a little digging, and there is one thing you can do. It's going to be gross, though. Alcohol has a byproduct that, once digested, it's actually poisonous. If you're going to drink alcohol, it might be a good idea for you to regurgitate the contents of your stomach before going to bed, as this will prevent you from absorbing the poison. Now, I'm not going to condone, in any way, shape, or form, bulimic tendencies. I actually used to be bulimic, and it is not a good thing. It does not promote good dietary practices, but in regards to drinking alcohol, I can see the benefits of it as opposed to the adverse effects that you would have if you allowed the alcohol to stay in your system. So that is my recommendation. Make sure to shop on the perimeter of the store, the living foods. If it resembles what God intended it to look like, you can be sure it's okay to eat, all right? Vegetables, fruits, dried fruits, nuts, seeds, legumes, whole grains, meats, etc. You should include these items in your diet when at all possible. This should be what your diet consists of, but I understand that we are busy people, we lead busy lives, we're professionals. We don't always have time for that. We don't always have time to cook, all right? Learn to cook using whole foods. I recommend getting a crock pot, okay? These are going to be invaluable in regards to being able to make huge meals, and you don't have to be there. You just dump everything in, voila, you're home, it's done. When eating grains, nuts, seeds, and legumes, make sure to soak or sprout them before you use them. This will ensure that they are nutritionally available to you, and in some cases, sprouting actually increases their value as a food. Use natural sweeteners in your drinks and recipes. Raw honey is optimal. You can use agave nectar, molasses, cane juice crystals, and my favorite is liquid stevia extract. Include some vegetable and natural fruit juices, if at all possible, in your diet. Pure, raw juice is a great way to get your intake of enzymes and vitamins without having to cook or prepare or chew a whole bunch of veggies that would take forever. You can keep the fiber in the drink as an added benefit or remove it based upon your preferences. Doing this regularly will help to detoxify your body and secrete bile into your digestive tract, making sure you have good digestive health. Also, include lacto-fermented foods in your diet. Sauerkraut, pickles, kimchi, make sure they're not pasteurized. You can make it yourself if you want. They're a good source of beneficial flora or bacteria and also of enzymes which help you digest your food. Each time you cook food, you are losing enzymes that your body has to make up for by secreting its own, which means you have less enzymes doing work in other areas of your body, and it also increases your chances of food allergies as the immune system takes on the role of the digestive system, meaning you are more susceptible to getting sick. If you eat dairy products, make sure to include lacto-fermented and cultured dairy foods like kefir, yogurt, and cultured cheese and butters. See where I'm at, 7:30. Alright, don't ever stuff yourself. Listen to your body, and when you feel full, stop. Stuffing yourself can lead to constipation and force your body to absorb toxins that would otherwise exit your body. On a personal note, I typically do not eat until I've had a bowel movement. I know that's gross, too much info. One thing that helps is to drink a glass of water with about 1 to 2 tablespoons of apple cider vinegar, some stevia and honey for sweetener, and lime juice for taste. You can also drink the juice of dark leafy greens or broadleaf grasses. This will cause you to secrete bile and invoke peristalsis, the means by which the intestines rid the body of waste through movement of the digestive muscles. Alright, and I have experienced that. After drinking barley grass juice in a matter of minutes, I was ready to go. So, just fair warning. There are no rules about when you should eat and what you should eat, but it is typically a good idea to include some protein in your breakfast. Not a protein shake, those have their own problems. But some source of protein and some fat, like butter or avocado or coconut oil or fish oil. This will keep you energized and happy throughout the day, make you less hungry, and encourage your brain to function optimally. Snack throughout the day on fruits and sprouted nuts and seeds or sprouted grain breads, and try to include at least a raw food source in each meal and a lacto-fermented food if you can. The more you eat throughout the day, the less hungry you will be at mealtime, so keep your portions small and listen to your body. Eating meat once a day is plenty enough. Try to increase your intake of vegetables and fruits. Juicing will help accomplish this. If you are cooking your vegetables, try to leave them slightly raw. Just heat them up slightly. Make sure you always have water on hand. The more water you drink throughout the day, the less likely you are to absorb toxins that would otherwise be expelled. I prefer filtered water. I have a Berkey water bottle. It was about $20, but it's worth the buy in my opinion. I'm avoiding fluoride and chlorine and other environmental toxins in my water source. Make sure you take time to breathe throughout the day. Most of us go around breathing shallow breaths. Take a moment every half hour or so to deep breathe. This massages your organs and your digestive system as well as your diaphragm, and increases the blood flow of oxygen to your brain so you can function at optimal levels. Take stretching breaks.